personal moments and broadcast them to everyone. I share my emotions with you, and you alone. What gives you the right to distribute them to the world? I only gave you them to borrow. They were not yours to give away. We have known each other since we were young. I knew I loved you from the moment I saw your first show. That night in Montana was magical. The bartender made me feel right at home. She kept bringing us wine. It was like she knew you. Thinking back, she probably did. It seemed like everyone there knew your name. You were so popular, but that night, you chose me. Our conversation drifted from science to horses to even the occult. You had such a beautiful mind. You seemed perfect. I was fooling myself for a long time. I thought next time would be different. The next script, or the next, or the next. But it never was. You paved the way for your career with my stories, my feelings. I love you, but I cannot read one more manuscript or see one more show where our lives are put on display. I'll be back tomorrow to gather the rest of my things. Please, do not be here. I couldn't stand to see you.
Mary, please don't do this. I couldn't continue with you gone. I never wished to hurt you. I was just writing what I knew. I have been given a gift to write, and I've worked so hard to make a way in this world for us. Everything I ever wrote was a dedication to you. I never meant to defile our memories. Now, I know you may not like this argument, but I never wrote the exact situations. It was all made up. Clarice was meant to represent who you are, not be a mere image. It wasn't you precisely. I mean, there's a you that you decide to show, the one I see, the one I interpret, and finally the one I write into the script. There are so many levels of diffusion, it's barely you at all. No one I love would fit into some theatrical mold. You, my dear, can never be simplified to a one-sentence character description. Mary, I love you. Please stay.
Why did you write me back? I know this is all interpretation. The goal of art is to represent, not replicate. I know this. No matter what lens it's washed through, it's still our lives. It's my life. My private emotions. People probably think I'm an awful person.
Well, there are good things there too, Mary.
The filler scenes. The good ones are filler, and everyone knows it. You said some of it was real, and some of it invented. It was all real to me. The way you saw those scenes, I could translate them. I knew what you were trying to say with every line and each action. I can always understand your writing, Freddie. I've always understood you.
If you really understood, then you would realize that I never meant to hurt you. How many poems have I read you? How many times have we gone through those scenes together? Not once did you tell me to stop. Not once did you even whisper the fact that I was hurting you with every word my name drew to the paper. How am I supposed to stop something I don't know about? How am I supposed to stop hurting you if I don't know I'm hurting you at all?
I couldn't say anything. If I did, you would stop writing. You're the artist, Freddie. How could I live with myself if I forced you to send this yourself at every turn?
I'm gonna change the scenes more, Mary. Distorted them more. I would put a funhouse mirror in for them. Every scene that was necessary.
That is too much work.
Not if it was for you. I would change every page, flip every lonesome word, and twist every solitary sentence. Watch the show with your heart and skin.
I never thought of it that way.
I know you didn't. I never meant to hurt you.
I don't know.